Welcome to our new episode of Bridging Voices, podcast series of the Multinational Development Policy Dialogue of Konrad Adenauer Foundation in Brussels.
My name is Dennis Schrey. Our guest today is Jakob Wöllenstein.
Is the Belarusian opposition united? What are the current tactics of the opposition movements and the government to gain political ground?
Over the last decades, the Belarusian opposition has been very good in fighting among itself. However, this time the situation is different because they have the strong conviction that they are not just an opposition, but represent the majority of people in Belarus. However, the situation is complicated. Many of the leading figures and faces are in prison in Belarus. Many had to leave the country, some reside in Vilnius, some in Warsaw. And although there are several different personalities, leading figures, initiatives and groups among the democracy movement, to the outside they have shown a strong and impressive unity. They remain united around the three big demands, which are immediate end of violence, release of the political prisoners, and new free and fair elections in Belarus. Just this week, leading figures and faces of the democracy movement have convened near Vilnius for 2 days to decide upon strategy and of common areas of cooperation and intervention to provide support for democracy in Belarus this year.
In the current context, how should the EU further support the democratic forces in the country?
The European Union and its member states have been using methods both of sticks and carrots. However, many people in Belarus were disappointed about the sanctions so far, saying that it does not include the right people who should have been put on that list. So if the European Union comes together for a fourth round of sanctions, they should put a lot of thinking into this to make sure it really targets the people who are responsible for those crimes committed against Belarusian citizens. On the other hand, the European Union is always better and louder at showing support to victims of repressions, to civil society in Belarus, and they should start speaking even louder about economic support and cooperation in the future with Belarus. Last but not least, the European Union can use its full potential of diplomatic channels, both reaching out to the regime in Minsk if they're willing to engage into a dialogue to explore that possibility, but also to talk to Moscow, who has a role to play in this game as well.
Remember to follow us on our social media channels. You can find all the links in the description.